Today's makeup is all about showcasing a new lipstick that I've got by St. Renais called Puglia. It is a gorgeous red shade, so something very Christmassy. Now, warning, I'm going in heavy with my base today just because it is a red lippy, so I thought, why not? First, I am using the Youngblood Mineral Loose Powder. Now, this is in warm beige, and I'm buffing it on with a kabuki brush. And this is easy. You can just layer up as you need and really build up that coverage. So I'm just placing that on and buffing it in and in around my cheek there. I've added a little bit much there, but as you'll see, the more you just buff it in, it'll just buff out nicely. Helps to sort of knock out that redness as well. I'm just making sure I get my entire neck as well, and I'm going down my décolletage. Now, this is a little bit different. I'm using a beauty blender, and I'm going in with the liquid foundation over the top. Now, I know this seems like a bit of a no-no, but this creates that nice dewy look, which I feel sometimes I lose when I use a mineral, like a loose powder. So I'm just pressing that in over the top, and my beauty blender is a little bit damp to start off with. So this will just give me that nice sort of glow, and again, some extra coverage. So yes, we are going in hard with the base today. This is the McoBeauty Contour Wand, and I'm going to contour my face and down my nose as well. So going in with a bit of contour too. I found I used this beauty blender again, but I have found that it's taken off some of that contour. So I will go back in with some powder contour later. Won't worry about that just yet. So we're going to start with, this is the MAC Paint Pot in Painterly. I'm using this as the primer for my eye and just prepping that eyelid. But before I go any further, these eyebrows are annoying me, so I'm just brushing them out. So just pressing that in with my finger and all over the mobile lid. This is the Sophisticate palette by Charlotte Tilbury. I'm using the white or the lightest shade, going up under the brow and then in the inner corner and over the mobile lid. Already, just using this one shade, you can already see how it's carved out the shape of my eye. So very, very kind of light on the eyes. This is the light tan shade, and I'm just creating a contour, like a bit of a crease there, because I'm going to do a winged eyeliner. So I figured a nice red lip suits a winged eyeliner. And when you're doing a wing, I don't want too much on the eyes, but what I do want is just that bit of shape. So just using that nice tan shade to create some shape on my eyes and help lift them up a little bit. The eye pencil that I'm going to use is the Youngblood Mineral Cosmetics one in black. And I'm really laying it flat. It's very sharp, I've just sharpened it. Laying it flat across that lash line. And then I'm picking up a little point. I'm making sure my eyes are open and smudging it out with my finger. And yes, it doesn't look neat to start off with. Once you've smudged it out, you can fill in that crease. And then I'm going in with a very detailed angle brush. This is by BK Beauty. I've come back in. Don't do what I just did then when you're doing it in a couple of different strokes. Try and keep it in one stroke, it is easier. I've kind of really messed that up a little bit, but I did go back in with that pointed angle brush and just tidied that up. Same thing on this side, I've done this one a little bit better. And you'll find it is difficult to try and get them exactly the same with these wings, but I feel if you open your eyes and then lift that up in that outer corner, it really helps. This one was a little bit easier to do. There's that angle brush again, and I'm just really blending that into the lash line and tidying up that line. This is on my tight line. Sweeping some of the Prometics mascara in to my lashes, and that's just building that up on the bottom ones as well. This is the On Point Brow pencil, and this is in blonde. I do have some product in my brows already. That's why it didn't really go in very well, it's quite stiff. So that was from this morning, so I'm just brushing that through. Now connecting that bottom lash line with the top, just to give it a little bit more of a seamless look. Now here we are with the Puglia. This is bright red. Now I'm not a huge lippy girl at all, okay? So red lipstick for me is quite dramatic. So I've gone in a few times with this detailed brush to really get that line correct. I do like to stay with my lip line, however, I am overlining it ever so slightly, and it did take me a little bit to get it even through that Cupid's bow. It still looks a little wonky, so I'm going to just fix that up. And then going in with the lipstick like that. Now, this is lip and cheek, so I popped it on my cheek and realized, holy cow, that is very full on. So I've gone back in with the Beauty Blender and blended that out a little bit. Same on the other side, and just blended that out. So the color payoff is huge, it's very good. Now, this is the Poni Cosmetics. This is a chocolate bronzing powder, and I'm just going in to really lift that contour that I did earlier. I think it just looks so much better if you just give that a little bit more definition there. Now, I will go in with some concealer. This is from McoBeauty. Now, I have found, as I did this, I put a little bit too much. Every day for me, I actually don't use much concealer at all, and you can see that I've just put a little bit too much and I'm really having to blend that out. But what you can do is use it to clean up that line that you've made with your eyeliner. So just get it really, really close and just clean up that eye. I'm going to set that with the Youngblood Mineral Setting Powder. This is in light, and just a detailed brush to set those areas just so that the product doesn't move. Now we're going in with the Saint Renais. This is the gloss and it is called Tropea. So there's the final look.